If there is one topic we should agree on, it is this. Earth is a living organism, and if it dies, we die. I picked my nephew Tommy up from school last week. Usually a happy kid, but today Tommy had a frown on his face as he walked to the car. As he got in the passenger seat, I said, T, what's wrong? He said, Uncle, why don't people get it? I said, get what? What do you mean? He said, the need to take care of our environment is so obvious. I said, well, break it down for me. He said, trees clean the air. Man builds factories. Factories poison the air. Man destroys trees. Man breathes the air. Man dies. Wow. And after I picked my jaw up off the ground from hearing one of the most profound statements from anyone, let alone a 9-year-old child, I said, then I guess factories will rule the earth. We both awkwardly laughed. And later that night, I couldn't help but contemplate, will this truly be humanity's fate? Shall we be the accomplices to our own destruction, victims of our own corruption, ambition, and overconsumption? Like a man addicted to drugs, every society thinks it can't happen to them. Until it does. We are the most advanced species to ever exist. But sometimes I wonder if some future alien culture will look back on us as nature's failed experiment. Evolutions could have been. You know, like that basketball player everybody said was better than Jordan but never reached his peak because he got caught up in the streets? Will we be another example of wasted potential? I don't mean to go existential, but every day corporations sell millions of smartphones, smart TVs, even smart water. But smart people seem to be constantly on back order. Maybe that's an oversimplification or an understatement. Nonetheless, the fact remains that we human beings make machines to fix problems that we created. Everything we do is overcomplicated by design. I mean, there's 19 damn ingredients that go into McDonald's fries. My God, why do we choose greed over need, profit over people, price over cost, sufficient over efficient? If this is the quintessential definition of intelligence, then where can I sign up to be primitive? I remember when my science teacher told me that asteroids were the cause of extinction. Today it's us. Thanks to man-made climate change, 100 innocent species go extinct every day. Yet many continue to deny it, refusing to take an honest look at the science. Well, to you skeptics, please allow me to analogize it. Close your eyes and imagine that you're on a plane with 100 pilots. 97 of them say, we are headed for disaster if we do not change course and reroute it. 3 of them say, they're all lying. It's a conspiracy. Don't worry about it. Even if you believe those 3 pilots are correct, wouldn't you take precaution anyway, just to hedge your bet? Well, this is the same situation we face with climate change. 2,000 scientists in 200 different countries have concluded the same thing, that we are on a crash course for devastation. And if we do not pump the brakes, spaceship Earth won't make it. The time is now. We cannot delay. If you were on the Titanic and you could see the iceberg in advance, wouldn't you try to move the heck out the way? It is too late to be pessimistic. It is time to innovate. It is time to stop fighting the old system and start creating a new system where we support organizations and technologies that not only have sustainability, but thrivability as the endeavor. We will get out of this mess like we've always gotten out of things. Together. Togetherness is the solution we require. And once we realize the power we have together, for the second time, mankind will have discovered fire, and he will shine bright as a species in all of his brilliance, finally arriving at an equilibrium.